Hi Sagittarius, welcome to Meraki the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and this is going to be for your October 2018 reading for Sun, Moon, Rising, Sagittarius. I have some clippers here. Some of you are having sleepless nights or you are just thinking about a situation like you are just thinking about few things that is occupying your mind, like some idea or something that is keeping you awake at night. You are not able to be be at a calm place because there is something which is coming up again and again, and it is driving you a little bit insane, if I can say, or it is just keeping you restless at the minimum. And then it can be related to work, or it can be related to something that you are supposed to do with other people, like you are supposed to partner with other people, and either somebody is not working according to you or you are not getting the right company, basically like right group of people to work with. Or I feel that at workplace you are not getting promotion or you are not getting promoted in a way that people are not recognizing your work or not giving you credit for the work that you have done, or whatever that you are doing is very the recognition that you are getting is like it's being delayed, or it's not coming to the final you're not getting the final permission is what I'm getting here. For some of you that is the case, and for some of you I'm getting that you are not getting the job that you want, or you are not getting success at it. Basically the word is success. You are not feeling successful, or you are not feeling like I'm also getting that some of you are awaiting success so much, like you are waiting for success to such a level, like you are imagining it to such a level that it is making you a little bit like you are in your head and you are thinking and imagining about the success that you will have and when you will have and what you will do with it. You are thinking about all those things, and some of you are graduating or completing something and you are wanting to get your degree and finalize something, so something related to that is coming up. You could be dealing with a Scorpio, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Taurus, all these signs, and yes, Aquarius, definitely some of you are dealing with an Aquarius or somebody who is some of you are working in a healing, either you are working on healing yourself or you are following your dreams, and you are very, very hopeful about this project that you have undertaken, and you want to experience success and you want to experience growth in whatever that you have undertaken, the work that you are doing with other people. So yes, you might be working day and night to build something. If you are not doing that, if this is not resonating with you, the messages so far, what I'm getting here is that it is time for you to stop awaiting and start doing. Yes, because some of you are definitely going through a heartbreak because of which you are not able to complete a cycle when you should have completed that cycle long ago, and you should have let go of something long ago, but you are still holding on to something that has already ended because you feel that there is still something left for you to gain from this situation. But no, there is nothing gained. Everything is balanced for good or for worse, and you need to move forward and not hold yourself back from something that is already waiting for you, like it's already in line, and you need to just focus on it instead of focusing on your past. Yes, some of you definitely heard. And before I turned on the camera, these three were the cards that I already saw before I started shuffling again. I ignored looking at these cards, but again they have popped out, so obviously they have messages for you. Some of you are dealing with a Piscean person or some Libra, Aquarius, Gemini or Sun, Moon, Rising or someone of that nature. this person is probably very cold and cutting. Like they either this is you or this person is behaving in a way that they don't want to be hurt. They don't want to engage you emotionally. They don't want to make space for you. Or you are feeling like this toward other people. You are like, I am already hurt in the past. I have already been through bullshit. Kindly don't feed me lies anymore, because I want the truth and I don't want to get swayed by your emotions and stuff like that. And then you are isolating yourself, or somebody around you is isolating themselves, because they are probably very, very hurt and they are behaving in a way that they are defending themselves, and they have become very ignorant or ice cold, whatever, and they are blocking their heart basically. And what I'm also getting that you need to either look at this entire situation from a bigger picture. You need to understand their side as well, or this person needs to this person needs to come out of their dark place that they are right now, and they need to let me see what comes up next. So yes, this is what I'm getting till now. I'm also getting that somebody left somebody out in the cold, and somebody is feeling like they have been betrayed in a way that they did not see it coming, that somebody has left them in a very rough spot. Like somebody probably is feeling that they were not worthy, or somebody felt that they are not good enough. But that is a very wrong thing to think. Like, you can, yes, some of you are definitely dealing with a three-party situation and a betrayal. So somebody recently, some of you recently discovered that you were dealing with a third party, and that has completely left you shattered and betrayed, feeling like you were not good enough, and now you are blocking this person out because you are like, this is like horrendous basically, and you are pulling out your sword and you are ready to cut this person out of your life. This can be a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Of the third party can be the water sign. Yes, the truth has come to light. For some of you, Sagittarius, truth has come to light, and some idea has come to light, and justice has happened. You can be dealing with a Libra as well. So justice has come, and because of that, because the justice card is here, you need to accept things now, and there can be some separation, because justice is about separation as well. You're also getting Ace of Wands reversed, so there is loss of passion. Somebody is not enthusiastic and passionate anymore. They are not feeling that they have much left to give it to the other person. They feel that they have drained themselves out being with this person or in this situation. So you are leaving the situation with a very heavy heart. You are like, I have already invested so much in this, and this is not the person from me. I can feel it, because they don't pay that much emotional, like they are not trying to connect and they are not trying to invest as much as I am. So that is the feeling that I am getting here. Messages for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising. Messages for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon. Definitely dealing with a water sign, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer, probably at workplace, and somebody is hoping that this person will make an effort and try to and will communicate or will travel towards them. What are the messages coming in for Sagittarius? 10 card Celtic Cross, Sun, Moon, Rising. For month of October 2018. So, Father of Cups, Six of Wands, Star card, Wheel of Fortune reversed, Seven of Wands reversed. Definitely I'm seeing that you are feeling that there is some healing that needs to take place, and there is some idea that needs to be explored. There is something that you truly wanted, and it's a wish come true which will come your way, and you will have success in it. Definitely there is at least one person who is bringing you a solid offer, and you will feel victorious with this person if you and it will be a wish come true. On the other hand, if you were having a very bad time, that time is going to turn around and there will be good times that will come to you. And what I'm getting here is that you are dropping your defenses, like you are feeling defended and you didn't want to share your idea, or you didn't want to share your passion because you felt that there was something confusing and there was something which was not visible to you. So you were very defensive, and now you are deciding that I will drop this defense and be my confident self like I was before this entire thing happened, because that is who you are, Sagittarius. Yes, you were fighting for something. You kept fighting for this whatever that you were fighting for. You were climbing the ladder, you were in the battlefield putting up a fight for something that you really wanted. Now you are feeling like should I keep on going? So you are feeling like, should I give up or should I not? Because you feel that there is some injustice, you feel that there hasn't been equal give and take. So that is why you are questioning, should I keep giving to this situation? Should I keep investing in this situation? Am I getting enough returns? You are definitely on a crossroad. You are trying to decide which path to take. You are definitely at least having two options. I'm getting seven options, but you have two definite options. So you will decide, obviously, like you are feeling like, I have seen so much in this world already. I have experienced so much already. Now what is that I haven't done up till now, which I really, really wanted to do? So you want to take up that path. You are trying to understand how to take that path, how to make up your mind, how to make yourself ready to go on that journey. Like I said, you are on a crossroad. You in past also, this is your past card, in past also you are trying to decide on something. You are not able to make up your mind. I think this is since July you were trying to decide on something, and you are still stuck in this situation in your head. The thing is, you need to ask your heart. You need to close your eyes and answer. Like, the answer will come from within, and once that answer comes, do not ignore that answer. Try to follow that, you know, that path which is truly yours. You want stability in your life. Some of you really wanted to have a commitment, or you still want to ask somebody out for a commitment to take your relationship a step further. So this is what I'm getting. By the way, this is coming out in reverse. So I think it can also be that some relationship that you were in, it is falling apart, or you're thinking about it like, you know, should I try to still build this up? And some of you were trying to move out of the house, but you cannot do that anymore. There is something related to stability which is not working in your favor right now. Another four. So two, four, and four. This is in your future. So if you are thinking about asking somebody out for a commitment, I think the answer is no. Either you are denying somebody, or somebody is denying you. So this can also be related to a home situation. I think you were trying to buy a home or purchase whatever, and then that is getting rejected, or there is some offer which is being made to you and you're not liking the offer. you want to nurture what you already have. You want to nurture your resources, your surrounding, your home. You want to decorate your home, and some of you are trying to look after your family, some of you are trying to heal your own self. Like, you want to heal yourself, you want to nurture yourself. You could also be dealing with a earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. There is somebody coming your way with a very passionate offer. Like, they want to invest in you, they want to they are telling you that they have a lot of passion for you. And I think I'm getting some allergy or something. Yeah, give me a moment, guys. Yeah, so can be another fire sign like Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. This is you sitting here. This is you. You're trying to maintain some balance. You're trying to get stable. You're trying to get grounded. And somebody is giving you some idea, passion. They are probably asking you to come out and have fun, some sort of adventure trip or something like that. There is huge inspiration as well around you. Somebody is trying to cheer you up or something like that. I'm also getting there is some opportunity coming your way, which is like inviting you, and it is up to you if you want to take this up. I'm getting that for some of you it's a spiritual invitation, like something related to satsang or something like that. So you want to spend time with people who are like a club, like a group. So they have a similar mindset or something like that. Your hopes and fears. So you fear that you will get very addicted to something, or there is some chance of self-indulgence, or you are fearing that somebody around you or somebody that you are dealing with is a addict, or they might have fear and hopes. It can also mean that you will have a wish fulfillment in certain way. Like, I am getting if you will reject something in future, or if you will get rejected in future, there are few things that you will gain as well. Like, because of that rejection, something will come into your life which you will probably not realize. You will probably fear it. Like, you will be in fear. But actually, it's a blessing is what I'm getting here. Outcome is that you are gonna feel sad anyway. So when I was holding this card, which is Four of Cups, and then the card next to it is Nine of Cups, which is 4 plus 5 is 9. Outcome is 5. So 4 plus 5 is 9. 4 plus 5 is 9. So maybe you will face some sort of rejection here, but then and you will feel very, very disappointed. You will feel like you are in depression and something did not work out the way you wanted it to work out. Like I said, there was some commitment that you wanted from somebody, or some project that you needed to take forward, but it probably did not work out. But still, I'm getting that it's a blessing in disguise. I don't know why I'm getting that, but yes, there is that's a blessing in disguise, because the bottom of the deck here is the Sun card, the Happiness card. So yes, you are being blessed with something. I think spirit and divine, divine powers are with you, even though you are not seeing it. You are feeling a little bit afraid, or you feel a little bit it's not going my way, but it is going your way. Here you are trying to protect yourself, trying to protect your ideas, your dreams. You are working on yourself, you are protecting yourself, you are after your dreams, you are trying to nurture them. Like here you are trying to nurture your dreams, your project, your baby. Yes, just be mindful of where you are investing and how much you are investing. That is the concern that I am getting here, that you need to know where you are headed. definitely there will be justice and healing and wish fulfillment later on. So no matter how the thing, how it turns out, eventually it is going to be in your favor. So that was your reading for October 2018, Sagittarius. I hope you enjoyed it and it resonated with you. In case it did, kindly do drop me a comment. It will encourage me to keep posting on the channel. Thank you.